All right. I think we're ready to kind of get started. It's 9 a.m. It's exciting. It's still a little bit weird to kind of be back, speaking at conferences and seeing people in person. So I definitely want to extend kind of a warm welcome and thank you for everyone showing up. When we were originally planning this event, we were going to do it as part of Open Source Summit Europe, but we were lucky to have our collaborators in the Finos Foundation that were like, "Hey, we're doing something, in London. Let's see if we can make OSPOcon Europe." So, I definitely thank everyone for taking the time to show up. This is our first, OSPOcon, in Europe that we're doing. We recently held one in North America in Seattle, which was fantastic to kind of see our North American community. In terms of the event today, we have a lot of great talks, throughout the day planned. Just simple reminders regarding, we're all getting back to the whole conference scene, so we have very strict health and safety guidelines, at this event. So I'm sure you saw it as soon as you walked in. Be reasonable, respect people's space, and so on. There's little stickers you could put on in terms of indicating your level of comfort in speaking with folks. Typical things regarding like Wi-Fi passwords on the back of your badge and so on. So if you need anything, please reach out to either the event staff or Anne and I, and we'll help out. Also want to thank our sponsors that kind of came together to make this happen. So AWS, thank you for sponsoring this event from your OSPO. You have a great organization there, and the Alfred Sloan Foundation, which kind of helped bring some folks here. So thanks and welcome, truly welcome. So to kind of kick things off, before I hand it off to Anna, I'm sure a lot of you have kind of heard this phrase that every company is becoming a software company. And what's interesting is it's almost every week you kind of hear these quotes or stories from organizations that like, got to bring software development in-house, or we have to figure out how to build things ourselves, and potentially leveraging external folks. We kind of control our destiny. And there was a recent quote out there from Porsche, which famous automotive company, that essentially they need to embrace software as one of its core competencies. It's not something that they could just purely outsource or not really handle themselves. They establish an open source office because most of software these days is available through open source means and done through open source collaboration. And if you kind of hear the quotes and reasoning from Porsche here, it's basically they're getting higher levels of maturity through open source, lower costs, better transparency, faster development cycles, all things that benefit the actual end users of their product, which is vehicles. So and this trend is happening in all different sectors, not only just technology, but automotive. We're even seeing OSPO is being established in a variety of academic settings, research settings, governments, and so on. So the power of kind of open source to improve efficiency from a development perspective, from a collaboration perspective, is just it's happening everywhere. So this is just something to kind of keep with you today, as we kind of go through and hear different people speaking from their different perspective. And I think one silver lining of the pandemic has been, I think, it's kind of forced companies to accelerate and kind of deal with this issue essentially. It's kind of given them an accelerated digital transformation that they may have ignored or kind of deprioritized before the pandemic happened. So a lot of these organizations are establishing open source centers of competency or OSPOs, colloquially. Why are they doing this? And generally to have a in order to basically have a body within an organization to kind of truly focus on a particular problem is basically the only way to kind of really truly bring focus to something. And as open source percolates within an organization, generally you have a couple folks or single body that's generally responsible for the management of kind of open source policy. Sometimes a lot of these open source organizations or OSPOs are focused on it's either developer efficiency, it could be compliance, it could be fostering business and partnership relationship, it could be helping with hiring. There's kind of a variety of different things that you have to do to kind of truly participate in an open source ecosystem and actually see the benefit, you know, from an organization perspective. So, Quillically, these kind of open source center of companies that are called OSPOs, they've kind of existed for, it's about 20 years maybe officially, based on the first name. I think if you kind of look at the history, one of the first OSPOs came, from kind of the mid-90s timeframe. If you remember, a company called Sun, they were doing a lot of open sourcing from things like Solaris and all this stuff. And so they established what is kind of almost known as like one of the first OSPOs. But if you look at the software industry in general, developers have been sharing and collaborating software like way back to like, the 50s, 60s mainframe days. But I think, from a company operational perspective, I think it wasn't truly codified as, a business unit or a particular type of job until, the mid-90s. And, OSPOs generally don't have one particular way of being structured. A lot of companies do it differently depending on what they care about. If they're, shipping a lot of hardware devices, sometimes they see OSPOs very focused on compliance. If they're building, services, they may care more about developer efficiency and how fast your developers can build software. So there's no real one template. We put together, a little, kind of definition. We call it the OSPO definition that we kind of steward within the two group that kind of tries to explain this to a wider audience. But that's basically it from what an OSPO is in terms of how things are kind of typically structured. We've also been cataloging things in terms of like different OSPOs out there. A lot of companies sometimes have a very easy external public page, right? VMware has a great open source OSPO page, Intel, right? Twitter, Facebook. But we've started to kind of catalog a lot of these things across different industries and a lot of tools that OSPOs use. I highly encourage you to take an opportunity to contribute to this. For some of you who know me from my kind of Kubernetes cloud native life, we have a version of this that's a little bit larger, focused on the cloud native ecosystem. But these things are just generally useful for you to kind of bring in catalog and build a community. So we'd love people to kind of contribute to this as we kind of build this out. Another thing that we do is we produce a lot of kind of interesting research and reports regarding the state of OSPOs. We've been doing this OSPO survey for about I think four or five years, depending when you want to look at it, when we started it. Basically, surveys, the whole kind of, wider, usually tech industry, but we've cast a wider net recently in terms of like, how is your OSPO structured? Are you planning to do one? How many employees do you have? What benefits do you receive? And so on. And so we've had kind of great data, over the years, and we recently shared and the results from the 2021 survey, and you kind of see, the benefits. A lot of people are interested in, increasing the funding in their open source initiatives. A good portion of folks are considering an OSPO, even though this is still a very new and nascent thing in the industry. A lot of people are kind of looking at, establishing and forming, these. So take a look. The great thing about, the To-Do group is we basically share an open source, everything that we basically do. So please take a look at it if you're interested in this kind of research. And more importantly, it's an open process, in terms of like the questions. We basically run this as an open source project. So if you're interested in particular questions or things that you want to see in the survey, please open up an issue. It's as simple as opening up a GitHub issue. So other than that, I kind of want to finish this welcome here and hand it off to Anna to talk a little bit about the kind of next wave of OSPO development and kind of other interesting programs within the To-Do group and a lot of her work in Europe. As I said, I'll be around pretty much all day. If you want to kind of talk a little bit about open source, OSPOs, other topics, I'm happy to kind of take the time and talk with you all. But other than that, I'd like to hand it off to Anna to kind of lead us through the rest of the day. She'll be serving as your official MC also today. So without any further, Anna, feel free to kind of take it up and go for the next step. So thanks all, and good to see you.